Going along easily back there in the clear. Then the stayer, Kirov Boy, down on the inside of the favourite, Blackheart Bart. Then My Sister Lil, wedged away inside of Bass Strait, spotting them all last is Belmont Girl as they come up towards the turn. 350 left to go and Resonates straightens up for home, leads from Fuchsia Bandana. Gee, a dream run came the way of Hazabil on the rail, a length Royal Rider, here's Wink and a Nod, and Blackheart Bart letting down as well. Resonates the leader, Fuchsia Bandana can't get to him, but here comes the big fellow, Blackheart Bart with Wink and a Nod with 100 to go. Blackheart Bart, Wink and a Nod in the middle, gather up Resonates, they go to the line, little in it, Blackheart Bart, Wink and a Nod.
Aaron and Vaughan, some horses just know how to win, don't they? And he's one of them.
Yeah, it seems that way. No, it was a very exciting race. It was great. We took it to Justin then. It was really, really good race, yep.
When we spoke to Glenn Smith after the first up win in the birthday stakes, he mentioned that he thought the horse was about 80% fit. We've seen that improvement again today over the 1420. Is he about right now?
Yeah, look, he hasn't blown a candle out there today, so I think we're looking at going down the right path with him, so he's there, I think, and we don't have to worry about too much more.
With the races being pushed back to Wednesday today, did it change your preparation? What have you done much or leading into this race today?
Yeah, it does. I mean, it's you just don't throw them on the truck and then go and take them home and throw them in the garage. It's you got to adjust, and it went against our training style a little bit, and it probably did with others too, for that matter, but... look, you just got to adjust and adapt to it and do the best you can.
Next will be the Listeria, obviously, and then to the railway. How are you feeling about the path that you've mapped out at the moment? Is it getting nervous as you get closer to these bigger events?
No, well, it's the only path that we could map out for them, and obviously it's fallen our way so far. So, look, we just hope that we still get a bit of luck here and there, and we can pick up the big one.
We've all seen the progression of this horse over the time, but compared to this time last year, how many more lengths would you put on it to say how much better he is than he was this time last year?
I wouldn't put any lengths on him at all. He's always had the abilities. He's probably just matured a little bit in the head, probably become a little bit more tractable than anything else. So that's always going to put him in better stead. But apart from that, no, he's always had that ability, so yeah.
You scratched on approach today and nominated now for Saturday. Looks pretty hard to beat as well on the weekend.
Yeah, look, he's probably better suited over 1200s and that, even though he's run some mighty fine races over 14s. If he was in that race there today, he might have proved pretty hard to beat with the rail being out like it was. But we decided to not go down that path. We thought we'd go stick to the 1200. And because he's probably more destined to the shorter courses.
Vaughan, it's great to see Blackheart Bart back in WA, doing the best and winning these tight finishes. Congratulations.
Yeah, thanks, mate.
Smithy enjoys the photo finish at the moment.
He loves it. Yeah, at least he's sticking his head out in the right place.
He's certainly running on well. I mentioned to Vaughan there that you mentioned after the first run you thought he was about 80%. How did you feel out there today?
Oh, I still think he needed that run. He tracked up behind Lucy Beautiful. And I was still worried about the leaders skipping there. Willie's was hard to run down, and he sort of had him covered 200 out, and I reckon the last 100 he was really found wanting, and he just done enough because he's such a good horse to find the line and stick his head there first.
Although you had that concern at the top of the straight, is there still a lot of confidence when you're on a horse like Blackheart Bart, when you just know that once you ask for it, he's going to deliver?
Yeah, that's right. He when he was starting to feel the pinch, he wasn't, you know, usually a horse will just drop out. He just keeps trying. You could feel that he was sort of feeling the pinch, but just done enough to will himself across the line.
I asked Vaughan about it and he couldn't put lengths on it, but how would you say the horse is compared to this time last year?
Oh, just in maturity, I think he's improved that way a lot. You know, he was running off the track and doing all sorts of things wrong last time. He's slowly getting there, like we can see, even cantering to the barriers now. We can go without the clerk. He's just really grown up, and I think that's worth a couple of lengths just in itself.
Scary that he's maturing. Congratulations. Great ride again.
No worries. Thanks for that, Adam.